Thank you.
Rather interesting scriptures this other day. Hear about this fellow named Tobit, who really is a type of each one of us, living the Christian life amid challenges, opposition, and of course, if we do, we will be opposed. Remember, we stay true to our faith. And if you are faithful to what the church teaches, particularly things like pro-life, you're going to be opposed. Mm-hmm. You'll be banned from some people's company. They won't want anything to do with you. That's just one of many examples. But basically, Tobit was a man of principle. He had a good heart, and he knew what was right. And so they gave an example, of course, in this case, of, you know, a murder that took place. He was in Assyria at the time, which was a place that was really vicious. The Assyrians were vicious people, and they killed without any thought of anything. And he was there at the time in Nineveh, which should be familiar to you. It's this amazing city that, remember, Jonah got thrown out of the belly of a whale and told, go evangelize Nineveh. He didn't want to, but he did, and they all repented at that time. But nonetheless, we have the case of Tobit, who was also a very prayerful person, and frankly, he just did not care if anyone opposed him, or even if it would cost his life. Didn't matter to him. So he made the right choice. And then the question always for you and for me is, you know, do we make the right choices in our discussions with people? Or are we silent sometimes? Then we have the gospel reading, right, which again is a little bit about being a refugee. Now the truth of the matter is, apart from the politics today about refugees, legal and illegal and so on, we should be refugees from the values of this secular society, right here and now. And at any given time, there may be people who we meet, you know, who might be refugees from some very difficult situations. Maybe a very bad marriage that's abusive. There are all kinds of refugees. And the question always is that the Lord is looking, how do we react to that? How do we treat those who are not in the mainstream of contemporary society, which is headed in the wrong way? I think we know that. And how will we answer the Lord on that point? Then we have Jesus' parable, well, which is, of course, basically talking about the kingdom, which is the kingdom of, as the scriptures tell us, justice, love, and peace, holiness, and grace, of generosity, open hearts. That's the kingdom. And, of course, we know the kingdom was inaugurated by the Lord himself in his ministry. And this parable was directed to the Pharisees, the teachers of the law, who rejected him completely. And essentially, you know, Jesus is recalling the fact that all the prophets before him were rejected as well. Most all of them were killed for doing the right thing. And of course, we know that so was he. He was a refugee from that kind of society. Well, again, the question will always be, I go before the Lord, you go before, we all have to do that. You know, the Lord will say, tell me how you have loved. Because that's basically the final exam. It's not, why did you do this or not do that? Tell me how you have loved. Tell me the ways. And of course, the ways in which we have built up the kingdom, the ways in which we have addressed the needs of those around us, where we could, the ways in which we have been a good listener to someone who just needed someone to listen to. Oftentimes, you know, that's powerful. We don't realize that. Just attending to people's needs with kindness. How will we say? What will we say to the Lord? Because that's what counts in the end. So we give thanks for giving, for the Lord's giving us so many graces, so many blessings, the greatest of which we celebrate at every Mass, His Word, as well as, of course, the Holy Eucharist, and all the ability that we now have to go out and make a difference. As Mother Teresa said, the Lord does not expect us to do great things. He expects us to do many small things, but with great love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.